Hi, I am Julian Bro. I am an economist and policy specialist. Today, I will be teaching you about unemployment. We will be focusing especially on minimum wage laws. We will discuss what unemployment is. Then, we will see how the existence of unemployment could be explained economically. Finally, we will dwell on the potential effects of minimum wage laws. What is unemployment? First, we must define the workforce. The workforce is the total number of people who are able to work. However, this does not mean everyone in the society. Certain people are not able to work. For instance, children are not legally allowed to work. This means that people able to work or only people above the minimum age to be allowed to work, which, depending on countries, is between 16 and 18 years old. Additionally, people who are in jail, in the hospital, or in the army cannot work. Hence, we do not consider them in the workforce. Then there are the actual unemployed. Attention, in order to be considered unemployed, you must be in the workforce thus defined and willing to work. This is important as there are people who are in the workforce but who for some reasons do not want to work. More specifically, or not considered as unemployed, the retirees, the students, and those simply discouraged, not willing to work. The non-inclusion of discouraged workers in the unemployed can lead to an issue of under-reporting of unemployment. As a consequence, the unemployment rate will be equal to the number of unemployed people divided by the number of people in the total workforce. For instance, in the US, the unemployment rate was 5.3% at the end of 2021. So, how can we explain the existence of unemployment? A first explanation could be that it is natural. There would be a natural rate of unemployment. This could be the case when there are as many job seekers as there are job vacancies. In this case, unemployment just means that there is a normal time delay before every job seeker fills a job vacancy. It is also referred to as frictional unemployment. It is not a policy issue. Some economists say the natural rate of unemployment would be around 4 to 5%. But this is a debated issue. It is possible that it would have gone down between the post-war period and now. Then there is real, that is, non-natural unemployment. One can distinguish between two broad types of explanations for this type of unemployment. One type is structural explanations. For instance, one could say that there are inadequacies between the offer of labor and the demand of labor. Or there could be a suboptimal equilibrium with an initially insufficient demand of goods. Or there could be inadequate legal systems. For instance, according to classical analysis, minimum wage laws, which we will come back to. A second type is cyclical explanations. For instance, a surge in unemployment could be punctual and caused by an economic recession and/or deflation. And real unemployment can be a real problem. Why? Because if workers who could be employed or not employed, this means that they are not producing when they could be producing. This means that the GDP could be higher if they were employed. Thus, unemployment means a GDP gap. The economist Okun calculated that in the 1960s, in the US, for every 1% by which the actual unemployment rate exceeds the natural unemployment rate, there is a GDP gap of 2%. Actual unemployment is a big concern in terms of economic cost at macroeconomic level, and in terms of social costs, in terms of the potential individual sufferings of the unemployed. As a consequence, a lot of economists have tried to understand and fight unemployment. This has led to many competing theories. Let's look, for instance, at the effect of a possible policy, minimum wage laws. Minimum wage laws fix a floor to wages. For instance, in the US, it is $7.25 per hour. This is a common policy in a lot of developed countries, but its effects are very debated. Here, we propose two major streams of potential interpretations of the effects of minimum wage laws: a classical interpretation and a Keynesian interpretation. In classical analysis, the economy is in a state of optimal equilibrium. Demand and supply are at their optimal levels. Minimum wage laws mean increased labor costs for firms. As a consequence, firms lay off workers. This leads to an increase in unemployment. For Keynesians, the initial economy is in a state of suboptimal equilibrium. Demand is insufficient, and as a consequence, supply is too low. The introduction of a minimum wage means that poorer workers are now better paid. They spend this increase in their wages on consumption. This means increased demand, which will mean increased supply. All this is boosting the economy. This, in turn, has a positive effect on employment. Time for a quick exercise. What is the unemployment rate? 7.5%, 14.5%, 30.5%, or 0%? Let's first calculate the workforce. The workforce is equal to the population minus children, minus students, minus the hospitalized, minus retirees, minus those unwilling to work. Here are the numbers from the problem side. Population of 1,000, 200 children, 50 students, 5 hospitalized, 60 retirees, and 100 unwilling to work. Putting all that together, the total workforce is equal to 585. Now, let's calculate the number of unemployed. This is equal to the workforce minus the employed, equal to 85. Now, let's calculate the unemployment rate. It is equal to the number of unemployed people divided by the workforce, equal 85 divided by 585, which equals 14.5%. So your answer is number 2, 14.5%. A quick recap. We have seen that the unemployment rate is equal to the share of unemployed among the workforce. Unemployment can be natural or real. In the case of real unemployment, its causes can be structural or cyclical. Finally, we saw that there are competing interpretations of minimum wage laws. The classical interpretation states that they lead to negative effects, whereas the Keynesian interpretation states that they lead to positive effects. Thanks for watching. Check out Chegg for more resources on macroeconomics.